Morning, friends. Such, yes, you are the site in telecoms. Okay, then what do you mean by Sajjan Sphinx? So let us take as usual, and one end of the spring is resting on a fixed support or fixed surface. Let us take this is a spring which is fixed to the ground, and the other end is loaded. A load of some W is acting on the spring at the other end, but this load is not uniform load or gradually applied load. This is suddenly applied load. This is sudden loads. When the load is sudden, or when the load is of fluctuating type, when the load is of variable type, so you have different types of variable loads, cyclic loads, then alternative loads, fluctuating type of loads. Okay. So this, when you apply this type of variable loads on the helical spring at one end and the other end is supported, the deflection produced, the entire deflection is produced on the coils which are in contact with the load. Okay. And this deflection is not uniform in all the coils, and slowly the deflection which is produced at the top coils slowly transmitted to the adjacent coils. That means it propagates to the adjacent coils, slowly it reaches to the bottommost coil, which is the supported end. Then from here, this deflection once again reflects back, slowly it propagates to the deflected end or the loaded end. Okay, so that means when the suddenly applied load is acting on the helical spring at the free end of the spring, the deflection produced in the top coils is more, or the entire deflection is produced in the coils which are in contact with the load, and this deflection slowly propagates to the adjacent coils, and thereby it propagates to the supported end. Right? So the deflection which is reached to the last coil or the supported end coil once again reflects back and reaches to the topmost coil, which is the coil in contact with the load. So the time of propagation of this, deflection plays a vital role in the functioning of this helical space. Okay, so due to this propagation, so the uneven stresses or non-uniform stresses are developed in the springs, right? So when the time of propagation, when the time of propagation of this deflection wave is equal to the time interval between the loads, then resonance occurs. What is the term? Resonance. So when the resonance occurs in the springs, the time of propagation of deflection wave is equal to the time interval between the application of load, then the resonance occurs. What is the effect of resonance? Large deflections are produced. So due to this resonance, large deflections are produced. So large deflections causes uneven stresses or the large amount of, so if the deflection is more, stress is also more. So higher values of stresses are produced. Then the possibility of failure of the spring is more. Okay, so this phenomenon is called Sajjan Sphinx. This phenomenon is called Sajjan Sphinx. Right, once again, listen. So let us take a compression helical spring, which is fixed at the bottom end and free at the top end. So a load suddenly applied load is applied, let us assume that the suddenly applied load is acting on the free end of the spring. So the entire deflection is produced in the topmost coil, and thereby the deflection is transmitted to the adjacent coil slowly. So at the end, this deflection slowly propagates, and at the end it reaches to the supported end. The reached deflection once again reflects back to the topmost coil, which is known as the loaded coil. Okay, so the time of propagation of this deflection wave is equal to the time of time interval between the suddenly applied load, like this suddenly applied load generally you can observe in the wall springs, okay, ice engine wall springs. So the time of propagation of this deflection wave is equal to the time interval between the load applications, then the resonance occurs. The resonance causes large deflections. Large deflections obviously induces large higher values of stresses in the springs, which causes the failure of the spring or the premature failure of the spring. This phenomenon is called surgeon spring. So it is a dangerous phenomenon. That's why it must be avoided. So to avoid this, the frequency of the spring, the natural frequency of the spring, generally natural frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of delta by g. Is it right? Delta by g. You know delta equation. You can substitute here. And we have a standard equation. You can substitute delta 1 by 2 pi d cube n. D cube n divided by t square root of 6g g divided by, okay, so this is the natural frequency equation. So the natural frequency of the spring should be at least 20 times the power of the frequency of application of periodic load. This Fn should be at least 20 times the top frequency of load, so that you can avoid such springs. Okay, so this is one of the precautionary measure you can avoid the such springs. Okay, so similar to this, there are other methods to avoid the such springs. Or such springs can be eliminated by remote methods. First one is placing of vibration dampers. Are the friction dampers. The friction dampers are placed at the in between the coils. So here friction dampers are placed. First one is placing of friction dampers in between the coils, or particularly at the center coil, so that this deflection wave can be damped out very easily, so that you can avoid the propagation of this deflection wave. And second one is by using spring of high natural frequency, by taking spring of high natural frequency. And the third one is by using springs having pitch of the coils near the ends different than the center. So different pitches are considered. Pitch of the coil, P, is considered different for different coils. Okay, spotting will have a different pitch value. At the center you will have a different pitch value. At the end you will have different pitch values. So pitch is nothing but gap between the coils. Is it right? Distance, the axial distance between the adjacent coils is nothing but pitch. If we consider different pitch values, so the time of propagation of this wave is different for different coils in the spring, so that they can avoid the surgeon springs. So these are all the methods to avoid surgeon springs of helical springs or support cross section. Thank you.